गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर मुरली कृष्णा हियर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द केमिकल रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्कोहल्स। फर्स्ट वन आई विल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन। ऑक्सीडेशन, सो जनरली द फॉर्मूला ऑफ अल्कोहल इज RBH। फॉर एग्जांपल आई विल राइट CH3OH, दिस इज एन अल्कोहल, right? This is methanol. Now let's see what is happening in oxidation reactions. Right? In the oxidation reaction of alcohol, to maintain the tetravalency, here two points I am writing here. In the oxidation of alcohol, what is happening? The cleavage of OH bond. Cleavage means cutting, breaking. Cleavage of O bond H and cleavage of T bond H. Means this bond will be broken and this bond will be broken. Two hydrogens are removed, and to maintain the tetravalency, here you are going to get C double bond. Right? When alcohols undergoes oxidation, two hydrogens are removing and C double bond of group is coming in the product. As two hydrogens are removed, this reaction is also called dehydrogenation reaction. D means removing. You are removing two hydrogens, that is why it is called dehydrogenation reaction. And we will see the other examples of oxidations. For example, you take primary alcohol, that is RCH2. Primary alcohols and oxidation is aldehyde. Right? It is an aldehyde. Oxidation. Aldehyde on further oxidation gives carboxylic acids. This way the oxidation, generally the oxidation reactions are going to take place. Generally the strong oxidizing agent potassium permanganate is used. Even you can use chromium trioxide also, For example, if you take a primary alcohol, you take as a chromium trioxide, there also it is also act as oxidizing agent and you are going to get aldehyde. And one more oxidizing agent is PCC. This is very important. By seeing the word PCC, you need to remember it is an oxidizing agent. Pyridium, chlorochromate, pyridium chlorochromate, PCC, pyridium chlorochromate. This pyridium chlorochromate is oxidizing agent, children. This is a complex compound of chromium trioxide with the pyridine and HCl. Chromium trioxide with pyridine and HCl. This pyridium PCC, it is a complex of chromium trioxide with pyridine and HCl. Right? By looking the name PCC, you need to remember it is just act as an oxidizing agent. I will write one equation to show the oxidation reaction of this. Right? For example, you have this equation CH2CH, double bond is CH2. Right? If you take a PCC, you need to remember that it is an oxidation reaction. It will not affect any other part. Only aldehyde group is oxidized to primary alcohol. Here, primary alcohol and aldehyde. Right? This primary alcohol group is oxidized to aldehyde. CH2, CH, double bond CH. This CH2 group becomes CH2 group. This primary alcohol, even though here it is double bond, it will not affect. Pyridine chlorochromate does not affect the double bond. Wherever alcohol group is there, the alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde. This way, the PCC is very important. In board examination, they will give complete the following equation. They will give one alcohol and an arrow mark PCC, they will PCC means pyridine chlorochromate. It is a strong oxidizing agent. When we use this, we will get the RDO. And what about secondary alcohols? Now let me write once again. This is RCH2O. This is primary alcohol. Primary alcohols are oxidized to aldehyde. Right? RCH2O. The secondary alcohols are there. RCHRO. This is secondary alcohol. If any secondary alcohols are oxidized, secondary alcohols are oxidized to ketone. This is ketone. RC double bond one, that is ketone. Ketone. Okay. If at all tertiary alcohols are there, they do not undergo oxidation. If you use any strong oxidizing agent and the cleavage of carbon-carbon bonds takes place and acids containing a mixture of carboxylic acids, okay, and having less number of carbon atoms is formed. You take tertiary alcohol. If you take any tertiary alcohols, actually they do not undergo oxidation. No oxidation. But elevated temperature, if you use strong oxidizing agent, the carbon-carbon bonds will cleave, and a mixture of carboxylic acids having less number of carbon atoms are formed. Important point here. This is important. What is happening? Actually, tertiary alcohols, they do not undergo oxidation. But if you use any strong oxidizing agent at elevated temperature, means at a special conditions, higher temperatures if you use, and there carbon-carbon bonds will be broken and a mixture of carboxylic acids are formed having less number of carbon atoms. In applications, it is very important, children. Whenever tertiary alcohols are there, if they form a mixture of carboxylic acids having less number of carbon atoms there, you can expect a strong oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate at elevated temperatures you might have used. Right? And primary alcohols, one more reaction, last reaction, sir. Primary alcohols, if you send through copper metal at 573 Kelvin, you are going to get aldehyde. Means primary alcohols if you take, you will get aldehyde. And secondary alcohols if you take. Here also dehydrogenation is taking place. Here also dehydrogenation, hydrogens are removing. Okay, if you take secondary alcohol, same copper metal at 573 Kelvin, you are going to get ketone. This is ketone. If you take a tertiary alcohol, for example, CH3O, if you take this, here also copper 573 Kelvin, here aldehyde and ketone is not formed. Here you are going to get alkene. This is important. Tertiary alcohol. This is a tertiary alcohol. This is a tertiary alcohol. Tertiary alcohol, if we send through copper metal 573, it is also considered as oxidation reaction only, or dehydrogenation reaction, you are going to get alkene. And this is about the oxidation of alcohols, children. Yes, children, we'll continue. Now the reactions of phenols. Reactions of phenols. Here in phenols, the electrophilic substitution reactions are taking place, children. Electrophilic substitution reactions. This is the structure of phenols. In phenol case, the electrophilic substitution reactions are taking place. Right? If you take a dilute HNO3, dilute nitric acid, here ortho and para The electrophile is substituting the electrophile and go to plus is substituting at argon para position. So argon nitrophenol and para nitrophenol here. This is argo nitrophenol. Argo nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. Para nitrophenol. The mixture of argo nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. Why electrophilic reactions are taking place at argon para positions means because of the reference effect of OH group. Here it directs incoming group at argon para positions. Here the electron density increases. When you look at the resonance structures of phenol at argon position, this is argon position and this is this position para position. At argon position and para position, the electrophile. The electron density is increased, so it directs this phenol directs the electrophile at argo and para positions only. Here you can see what is the importance of this argo nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. This argo and para isomers can be separated by steam distillation. It is one of the technique to separate the argo isomer from para isomer, right? Argo nitrophenol is a steam volatile. This is steam volatile. This can be separated by steam distillation. Steam distillation. A mixture of argo nitrophenol and para nitrophenol is separated by steam distillation. And argo nitrophenol, which one is steam volatile? Means argo nitrophenol is steam volatile. Steam volatile. That is due to the intramolecular hydrogen bond. Intramolecular hydrogen bond. This is of the important intramolecular hydrogen bond. Whereas para nitrophenol, they have intermolecular hydrogen bond. This compound will have intermolecular hydrogen bond. Intermolecular hydrogen bond. Right here, intermolecular hydrogen bond is taking place. Association is taking place here. And whereas argo nitrophenol only intramolecular hydrogen bond is present. Right, children. That is why this boiling point, this the boiling point of para nitrophenol is less because of intramolecular hydrogen bond. Right? Yes. So the mixture of argo nitrophenol and para nitrophenol can be separated by steam distillation. In that, which is steam volatile means argo nitrophenol, which have low boiling point, will be the steam volatile, and argo nitrophenol is low boiling point. Argo nitrophenol is having low boiling point, it is a steam volatile because of intramolecular hydrogen bond. And same, if you change the conditions. Okay, for example, if you take phenol in presence of concentrated nitric acid, there you will get a picric acid, 2,4,6 trinitrophenol you are going to get. This is also important. What is the difference? You know, here only you are taking dilute HNO3, here it is concentrated HNO3. Here also nitro group, Okay, this is also called picric acid. Now, how to remember this? Here onwards, the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 2, 4, 6. Trinitrophenol. This trinitrophenol is called as picric acid. Important. Right? When phenol is treated with the concentrated nitric acid, you are going to get 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. This is picric acid. Even you can take phenol with the concentrated sulfuric acid, children. There 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. Right? Second position and fourth position and third position sulfonic acid group will be attached. 2, 4, 6, 3, 9, 3, 2, 4, 6 सल्फर फिनाल 2, 4, 6 फिनाल व्हाट यू हैव राइट देन फिनाल 2, 4, 6 फाइव सल्फोनिक एसिड राइट
यस
सेम फिनाल दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द केमिकल रिएक्शंस ऑफ फिनाल एंड व्हाट अबाउट द हैलोजिनेशन रिएक्शंस
Halogenation.
Can you take phenol? Right? If you react with iron bromide, it will react as a. Actually, the chemical reactions, halogenation, this nitration and all, they are called electrophilic substitution reactions. Here, even in the absence of iron bromide, even in mild conditions also the reaction is going to take place.
Bromine carbon disulfide also the reaction is going to take place. Right? A mixture of R-bromophenol and para-bromophenol. This is R-bromophenol. This is para-bromophenol.
Right? If you take just bromine water,
phenol is treated with bromine water, you are going to get 2,4,6 tribromo, 2,4,6 tribromo phenol, 2,4,6 tribromo phenol, 2,4,6 tribromo phenol.
Sir, see children here, these are the important things. Phenol only dilute, HNO3, you are got mixture of R-bromophenol and para-nitrophenol. The same phenol with the concentrated HNO3, concentrated nitric acid, 2,4,6 tri-nitrophenol, that is the thing. Same way, phenol with bromine carbon disulfide, R-bromophenol and para-bromophenol. Phenol with bromine water, the product is different. 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Right? And the two important chemical reactions are there. Kolb reaction and Raymer-Chamber reaction. That we will discuss now. Yes, sir. Now I am going to explain the Kolb reaction. In Kolb reaction, when phenol is treated with sodium hydroxide, you will get a sodium phenoxide ion. Right? This is sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide ion is more reactive towards electrophilic aromatic substitution. It is more reactive towards electrophilic aromatic substitution. So, when it is reactive with carbon dioxide, carbon dioxide in presence of acid, you are going to get a pick, two hydroxybenzoic acid, that is salicylic acid. Two hydroxybenzoic acid is also called salicylic acid. This is called Kolb reaction. Means introducing CO2 group or introducing carboxyl group at ortho position. How to remember this equation? Introducing COOH group at ortho position. Is called as Kolb reaction. When you take the phenol, you can introduce carboxyl group at ortho position. That is called Kolb reaction. And phenol is treated with sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium phenoxide ion.
sodium phenoxide.
Okay, this sodium phenoxide is a good electrophilic aromatic substitution. In presence of carbon dioxide, you will get it is more reactive. Sodium phenoxide is more reactive towards electrophilic substitution. Electrophilic aromatic substitution, when it is react with carbon dioxide at ortho position, carboxylic group is introduced. 2-hydroxybenzoic acid, that is salicylic acid is formed. Children, salicylic acid is formed. Right. Next chemical reaction, Raymer-Chemin reaction. This is also named chemical reaction.
Named chemical reactions are most important. Raymer-Chemin reaction.
Here, what here? By seeing this, the Kolb reaction is also most important. Here, introduction of aldehyde group at ortho position. What is the difference between these two? Here also you are taking phenol sugar. Okay, when phenol is treated with chloroform in presence of aqueous NaOH. Chloroform in presence of aqueous NaOH. Here, in the overall in the reaction, you are going to introduce aldehyde group at aldehyde group at ortho position. Right? Here O minus Na, O minus Na plus here CHCl2 will come. This is an intermediate compound. Okay, in this intermediate compound, then it is react with sodium hydroxide. Right? When you treat it with sodium hydroxide, then I keep the aroma in brackets, intermediate compound. When you take sodium hydroxide, you are going to get CHO group gets introduced at ortho position. Right? O minus Na. You can write Na plus. Right, children? At last, here in the reaction, in presence of acid, you are going to get salicylaldehyde. Okay? Here in base of NaH will come OH and CHO group is already here. This is what is the difference between these two? You see here. See salicylic acid, this is salicylaldehyde. Salicylaldehyde. Most important reaction signal these two. One is Kolb reaction. In Kolb reaction, salicylic acid, 2-hydroxybenzoic acid. It is salicylaldehyde. It is a Raymer-Chemin reaction. Or you can write 2-hydroxybenzaldehyde. 2-hydroxybenzaldehyde. You can see benzaldehyde. Right? These are the most important named chemical reactions in phenols. Kolb reaction, Raymer-Chemin reaction. Even in the examination, when you are writing, write like this. You have to give the statement and you have to write the equation like this. Even in the exam, directly you can write phenol is treated with chloroform and aqueous NaOH. And you are going to get salicylaldehyde directly. This and this is right on the mark. This is the mechanism. Intermediate compound will form when it is treated with sodium hydroxide. The CHCl2 group is converted to aldehyde group, and then in presence of acid, it will be converted to salicylaldehyde. Right, children. Next, reaction of phenol with zinc dust. With zinc dust, next chemical reaction. Already you have learned in 11th class, right? And phenol is treated with zinc. And phenol is treated with zinc. You are going to get benzene plus this zinc and oxygen, zinc oxide. This is benzene. Already you know the preparation of benzene you have learned. And last reaction, oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction. Oxidation of phenol. Right, when phenol, this is the phenol, children. When phenol is treated with the sodium chromate, oxidation of phenol with chromic acid, children. Chromic acid. Okay, Na2CR2O7, chromic acid, Na2CR2O7.
Na2Cr2O7. Here you are going to get benzoquinone. Benzoquinone formula double bond O. Double bond O. Here this is benzene.
Phenol is treated with chromic acid. Or you can take sodium dichromate. This is also called sodium dichromate. Here conjugated diketone, it is called as conjugated diketone. Why it is called conjugated diketone means conjugation means alternate double bond single bond like this. It is there, this is double bond single bond and single bond
continuous means double bond and single bond, it continuation is maintained, that is called as conjugation. Conjugated diketone will come, it is called benzoquinone. This is a special product, and especially when phenol is oxidized, in presence of chromic acid, right, you are going to get conjugated diketone. It is called diketone means two C double bond groups are there, that's what it is, diketone. And this is the a special reaction of phenol, oxidation of phenol. When phenol is oxidized in presence of chromic acid, I can say sodium dichromate in presence of sulfuric acid, conjugated diketone, that is benzoquinone will come. These are the reactions of phenol. Right? Thank you.